Welcome back, YouTube, to another episode of American Truck Simulator right here on your boy channel, CBS Talker. And we are driving the Mack Anthem today. I just purchased this tractor from the dealership. I paid like maybe $169,000, or matter of fact, $149,000. And this is what we got. So I got my company color on it, all white. I mean, it can be all three of those colors right there. You got orange, black, and white. Which I already got a Mack Anthem with a mid-roof sleeper. Like a, you know, a more bigger sleeper. This is a smaller sleeper. So I don't got the bigger sleep. The bigger sleeper is the high roof. This is like a wing on top of the roof. So it's still like a mid-roof with a wing on top. Or like an air slope or whatever it's called. You know, for wind, more fuel efficient type of stuff. So this is smaller sleeper, that's not the biggest one. The biggest one like 200 G's. I don't have that kind of money spending right now on the truck, but we're gonna use this. And I put some running lights on the back of the sleeper. Got like what, 4 of them up there. I'm taking it to the shop right about now and then change the color of it. I'm gonna do black with the white and orange stripes on it. So I'm gonna change the color of it, the truck. And that's it. I'm keep the rims and everything else the same. I'm gonna add a little bit of lights around the door side, right down to the door, some marker lights. And that'll be it for that. Keep the mud flaps the same, whatever. You know, keep it the same way you look right now. Just put a different color on it. So right now I'm at one of my biggest headquarters at my company is Kingdom Industry, Kingdom Incorporated, something like that. Yep. So we gonna do that. We about to get a trailer real quick. I'm gonna add a trailer onto my backside. Let's see. I don't know if I'm gonna use my trailers or I'm gonna go pick up a load from a different from a company and use their trailers, because they pay a little bit more better, I think. So let's check them out. Let's go to loads real quick and see what they got out here for us to carry. And later on, I'm gonna buy this Peterbilt 379. Yeah, I think I'm liking that. I'm heading down that way right now to go check it out. So we might not make it in this video, but we'll try to get it in the next one. Okay, so we got this one heading all the way to $40-something. $41,000 for clothes. Fireworks. Let's see what the local runs look like. I don't want to head that way. I'm trying to head to a Peterbilt dealership. Yep, so we're gonna take this load right here of gravel. Let's see what alcohol is. What alcohol is? Oh, alcohol did. No, me on it. So we're gonna take this load to from Las Vegas to Carlsbad again, California. And this load right here will pay us out $16,000. We're gonna take the gravel load right here. It's gonna take us all the way down this way here. That's where we wanna be at. That's where the Peterbilt dealership at. So that's where we headed. Let's do it. So I accept the load. I'm gonna head to the dealership real quick. I'll change my color first. So I got a Detroit engine inside this bad boy. I take the stacks off it and put it under the truck. So it's the mufflers under the truck instead of in the way of the back of the sleeper, because I wanted to show off my running lights in the back. So I want it kind of clean back there, you know, the custom look, whatever. So let's get it going, man. Everybody who play American Truck Simulator, y'all know this ain't the sound of this Mack Anthem. This Mack Anthem is very quiet. So I'm running some mods inside this game here to be able to get the sound of the truck. So right now we pushing 515 horsepower in the Detroit engine. I don't know what series it is, but I gotta look at all that when I get to the shop. Right now, we're just going right around the corner real quick. You can hear that turbo going. See what them Jake brakes sound like. So this is how the truck look inside. I gotta adjust my steering wheel real quick. So let me go ahead and do that right now. I'm gonna go ahead and adjust my seating. Y'all know I like to sit back. I don't like to be all up on the steering wheel like this. Let's go ahead and drop the seat. Put it back a little bit. A little bit more back than that. Let me get y'all turned this way like this, yeah. Yep. I want y'all to see all that right there. That's how I want y'all to be. I'm looking at this, something different. Closer here. All right, so let's get up in there. Oh, I didn't mean to go up in this thing. I mean to go. No. Just exit. So I'll be right back with y'all when I finish upgrading this truck real quick. So let me go ahead and see y'all in a minute. Alright y'all, so we back and we got the color of the truck now. And I like it. Got the black with the red, orange stripe. You got white stripe. And with the lining of it, it's going to be like a grayish color, which you can barely even see, but maybe if I go zoom in a little bit, you can see like the outside lining of it is gray. So that's the truck right there. I ain't never had the black company color, but we using the black for the first time on the truck. That's how I look with the back sleeper cab, right, lights running. And as you can see right there by the door, under the door, I put like running lights under there. You know? So it's looking good. Alright, let's get on with the get on. So now, since we got this done, we are going to pick up our load. Got a customized steering wheel in this truck. You know, normally I would stick my other truck, my other Mack Anthem got the original style wheel with all the buttons on it. This one I wanted to go a little bit different. So that's what we're doing. So remind y'all, we are heading to go pick up this purchase this what is it, the Peterbilt 379. That's what we're gonna pick up, but we gotta make this money first. So by the time I get to my destination, I should have my company drivers bringing in that money for me on top of what I bring in, so we'll be have be able to have enough money to buy. we almost there. Pick it up. See y'all when we get there. Alright y'all, so we got our load, and let's go ahead and look at our log books and see what we got to do before we get there. Alright, so I'm carrying a bunch of gravel right now inside this dump trailer. And we weigh about estimated 39,000 pounds, which is not accurate right now until we hit the scales. But that's just an estimate. Our destination is Carlsbad, California. We're gonna hit another bitumen location. That's basically where they do all the gravel digging and stuff at. Where they take all the stuff and make cement. I'll exit. Right now it's Saturday, 6 p.m. in game time. So we are expected to be there at Sunday, 4 p.m. to Sunday, 8 a.m. So in between those two windows, 4 p.m. or 4 a.m. or 8 a.m. We gotta get there. So this load is $16,000. The remaining hours on this load to arrive at this destination is 22 hours. We got 8 hours of sleep, so we'll be resting up. Probably driving at night, maybe. Yeah, we'll be driving at night. We got 349 miles to cover before getting there. That's a 7-hour drive in game time. Maybe an hour or two. But y'all know me, we gonna cut it short. So, let's go ahead and get on down this road. Powerful. Get up to 30 miles an hour, no problem. Sitting at this red light waiting for my light to turn green. We got the green. forgot to check and see am I driving a 13 speed, but we'll find out when I hit the interstate. How far the gears go. I think I'm at a 12 speed or a 13. Finished the construction over here in Las Vegas. Like they finally did the road and stuff. That's the update I get. Look good. Especially this detail about that building up there. Got like a whole lot there on that building. That's some good details right there. So right now we're in ninth gear. Trying to figure out if I got a 10 speed or a 12 speed or 13, one or two. Now we're in 10th gear. We got the road all asphalt out. Like, I like how the road look. Maybe you just want to stay right here in this area. I'm gonna do a video where, and I got daycare. I'm gonna get a daycare where I'm gonna just stay right in the same area and do like maybe 6 runs, you know, back and forth to the city, in the same city. All right, we're in 11 gear. forgot how this Mac app got a lot of body room compared to the other trucks I drive. This one seems like he's gonna flip over or something when I'm turning. I drive hard, I don't really, you know, I stay within the speed limit, but I'm more like in the hammer down lane all the time, you know. Maybe if I'm cruising and I'm doing a live stream with y'all one day, which I'm trying to get there, we'll settle down a little bit. Have to drop it down the gear real quick. So we're gonna drop off right there. Wait on that little red light right there to turn. I'm gonna put my flashes on. So we can get out of there. I'm gonna bust a big old U-turn. Wait for this damn light to turn. This light broken.